So the resolve property is basically a list of promises, things that need to happen before your controller will instantiate and your template will load and everything will set up. So it's a way of routing to say, hang on, I got some stuff to do first. So let's set up a resolve called app inside of a resolve property. This is basically going to map to our app controller. And we'll just say this is a function. And you get really, really used to an Angular, everything being a function so that you can inject stuff in. So the queue library is the promise library that we talked about. And from there, we'll just say queue, defer, and then we can return the promise from defer.promise. So you'll see right now, if we reload, nothing will happen because the promise hasn't been fulfilled. So if we say defer, resolve, and now we refresh, you can see that it works just fine because we've returned a promise and the promise has resolved. That means that everything can move on just as you would expect it to. So say, for example, what you'll see in a lot of the examples that show this, there's a timeout service you can use. It basically means it's a way of wrapping set timeout. So we'll just say resolve after 2 seconds. So now when I refresh 1, 1000, 2, 1000, and then it shows up again, 1, 1000, 2, 1000, and then it resolves. This is also useful for things like using the HTTP service and a whole bunch of other things you may want to do before your controller loads and the template fires up and you're ready to start working with what's changed in that route. We'll go into more detail in the next video.